Hello there, I'm John and Puss's name is Sooty. I'd like to introduce you to a way I've devised to slow the feeding of your cat. Sooty used to bolt her food and become rapidly sick afterwards. It is simply the addition of some glass or ceramic marbles to the feeding bowl. The bowl itself should be deepish with wall ideally around 5 centimetres and vertical to prevent Puss from flicking them onto the floor. I normally use a ceramic bowl, but to show how much tongue is used, I've used a clear plastic one as well. The principle is that the food finds its way beyond the balls and has to be foraged for using tongue and paw, time consuming and of course slowing. The number of balls is your choice, and as you can see, the bowl is quite packed with them, leaving space for about one more. If it's too solidly packed, food will get left, too few, and access is too easy. Whatever you can adjust the number to suit. Using tin food, I always add as much very warm water and use it and ensure it is well broken up so it settles well amongst and below the marbles. Any excess heat from the added water is quickly dispersed to make the temperature safe and palatable. She likes this mix, and the added water keeps her well hydrated. The marbles are easy to keep clean, cheap, and easy to acquire at stores selling Serendipity or any $2 store, perhaps two at some toy shops. Smaller marbles than 2 centimetres are less desirable regarding cleaning, allowing space for food to drift down and the unlikelihood of them being swallowed. Just putting food plainly on a dish offers no effort to eat nor any foraging action, which is exactly what happens in nature. Further to this end, some 10 minutes after a feed, I get some biscuits out for her to chase, catch or forage for one by one to clean her teeth after a meal, as one should, so to speak. Sooty has fared well on this regime. She's bright, active, and except for 4 meals, content. Some say she should be an ad cat. So we'll stop.